Dimitrios is currently the director of BIM VDC at AVVIR in New York City, leading the VDC reality capture operations team. By managing a data-rich virtual model of the building, he enables evidence-based, performance-driven decisions to be made during all phases of design and construction in support of high-performance buildings. Dimitrios has practiced architecture in Athens, London, New York, and Tokyo, and worked, among others, with Rafael Vignoli Architects in New York, where he founded the in-house computational research and design group, and at Foster & Partners in London, where he has introduced innovative computational design techniques into projects of design group three. So Dimitri's lecture today is titled AVVIR, a system of reality for buildings. So Dimitri,
thank you. Thank you for the introduction, and thank you for being here. Okay, so I'm gonna briefly speak about the company I'm currently working at, AVVIR, what we do and why we do what we do. And then I'm gonna jump straight into the demo of the actual platform, which is a web-based platform. So what is AVVIR? I guess that's me. And why AVVIR started? AVVIR started 3 years ago. The incentive for starting AVVIR for the founders was that construction is fundamentally an inefficient business. There's only there's $1 trillion spent each year on rework alone. And not only that, but also general contractors spend $6.5 billion just updating project schedules yearly, which is a lot of money just for doing reworks and updating schedules. AVVIR had a proposed solution for that using the digital twins. Briefly, what the idea is that you can spot mistakes early during the construction. You can track the progress and visualize it. And at the end of the process, you can facilitate the production of an accurate as-built model. How does that work? First of all, the customers have the ability to upload the BIM model from their office or home office these days on AVVIR's platform. The second part of the process is that either the customer or a third party company can go on site and scan the job site. And once they upload both the BIM model and the scan on the AVVIR portal, we have the ability to run an analysis by overlapping the BIM model and the scan in order to identify the mistakes on the construction and also the percentage of completion of the construction at any given time. Briefly, to do that, though, in order to have the ability to understand, for the platform to understand what is what in the BIM model, we enrich the BIM model with uniformat coding, which is basically means that it's a global standard for categorizing the different elements in construction. So you can see those codes like D2060 or Z1070, et cetera, et cetera, which we inject into the metadata of the BIM model in order to be able to later separate which trades are which and in order to facilitate the reporting. And you're going to see more in detail when we jump onto the portal. And we can do that using Navisworks. And what you can see is that, for example, we receive the BIM model, and in here, if you check the information of each element, the properties, it doesn't necessarily include that information. So once we inject that information, you can see on the right that this HVAC duct, for example, has this uniformat code D3050, and it can be identified by our system later on And it's it allows you to turn it on and off and also see it clearly in the reports. The second part of it, which was the reality capture I talked before, we suggest the two different types of scanners. So those are some of the scanners that we recommend to the customers. The one is the stationary scanner, which allows you to have really great accuracy during the scanning, but at the same time, it takes more time to complete the scanning and also process and register the scans. By register, I mean to stitch together different scans. And these days, mobile scanners are getting better and better. The resolution is not as accurate as the stationary scanners, but it allows you for much better, much faster turnaround time from many hours to few minutes. And they also allow you to automatically register those scans. So, so you have to find the balance between the level of detail you want to have during the scanning and the turnaround time you want to have. And customers these days are very much interested in the speed. I will say more than they are interested in the accuracy. So basically, you visit the site, you carry this handheld equipment, obviously wearing the personal protective equipment these days, mandatory on sites in New York, and you walk the site, each floor. Imagine you can scan a floor of about 2,000 square meters in about 15 minutes. And depending on the amount of completion of the build out on each floor, it takes a little bit more time if you have more walls up, or it takes less time, for example, if you are on the roof on the right, you can see you have less obstacles, so it's much faster to scan around. The final result of the scanning is this this type of point cloud, which is a relatively good quality, the specific one. Depending on the scanner you use, obviously the quality varies. So very briefly, that was a very high level summary of the processes and what we do. And I can jump straight onto the portal to demo live the platform itself. So the AVVIR platform is a completely web-based platform. So basically, you don't have to install any third-party software on your computer. Once we get the BIM model from the customer and it goes through the BIM conditioning process to assign the uniformat levels on each of those traits, this is what you get. This is what you see on the portal. You have here the full BIM mode. And it's fully integrated on Autodesk Forge these days, which allows for much greater speed, not only to load the model and navigate in the model, but also allows for higher complexity models to be loaded on the portal. And what you see here is similar to what you will see in any 3D CAD software like Revit, Navisworks, Rhino, etc. You have the different trades. The colors are the same as they were initially in the B model. And you can go in here and select each element, and you can see what category each element falls into. And you can, additionally, with the Forge buttons, you have some additional capabilities here. You can create sections in order to inspect the model easier, or you can take some measurements if you need to, etc. We talked before about the uniformats and how those are categorized, and where that comes into play is here. So you have the trade filter here, and you can turn on and off different trades. So, for example, I can go in here and I can say I want to turn off all the interiors. So I'm only left with all the rest of the trades I can inspect. And if I want to, for example, focus on large HVAC ducts, I can go into services and I can turn off plumbing, fire protection, electrical, and all the different service trades. And I'm left only with the HVAC, which is obviously much easier now to work with. So basically, this is what you can do in the full BIM mode. You also have the ability to turn on the point cloud. So remember, we upload the BIM model, but after we get the cloud, the point cloud too, we also upload the point cloud, and we overlap the two. So you that gives you the ability to turn on the point cloud in order to see and inspect how the point cloud is the as-built conditions are related to the design intent conditions. So this is the full BIM mode. When things start to get more interesting is that you can switch to AVVIR Progress and AVVIR Inspect. And AVVIR Progress, it gives you the percentage of completion of elements, and AVVIR Inspects will give you the elements that are deviated. I have already preloaded those for speed. So I'm gonna click in the next tab. So here is the AVVIR Progress view. And as you can see here, before you saw all the elements had the same colors and the same and they were all they had no transparency. So in this mode, you can see some elements are transparent and some elements are not. The transparent elements are the elements that are not built, and the solid elements are the elements that are considered to be built. And the algorithm is able to identify to by comparing the point cloud with the BIM model to identify which elements have been built and which elements have not been built. You also get a very high level report here of what percentage of each trade has been built. So for example, for interiors, 86% has been built, and for services, 61% has been built. And you can compare that to what has been reported on site to spot check if the information you receive from the site are accurate. You have on the top right corner a few reports you can export, one of which is the View Progress Report. What that gives you is this PDF, which basically tells you for each different trade how many of the elements have been completed and what percentage is completion, the percentage of completion. So this gives you a little bit more detail on what has been completed and what percentage of it has been completed. So for plumbing, for the 28th floor here, you can see out of the total 3,991 elements, 2,904 have been completed. And then you can go a little bit more in detail in here to see that from domestic water distribution, what percentage has been completed, sanitary drainage, what percentage, et cetera, et cetera. And if you wanna dive even deeper into the progress reporting, you can go in this advanced mode of progress report, which basically overlays the report that you get from the platform with the project schedule. So here you see the gray line is the project schedule that we receive from the customer. So for plaster and gypsum board, for example, the schedule was supposed to be this, but based on the scanning on those six different dates, we can see that if the trade partner has actually managed to complete things on time, or if they have fallen behind, or even sometimes they have completed more. For example, around February 3rd, they were supposed to complete 5%, but looks like they have completed 17%. But later on in June 2nd, they have completed 71%, while they were supposed to complete 99%. So they're falling behind. And that allows you to take action early on by identifying areas where the construction is going slower than the schedule. And that is the progress view. The things get even more interesting when you go to AVVIR inspect mode, which is this mode. So what you see here, the color scheme is even more simplified here. We only have white elements and red elements, and you can see transparent elements and non-transparent elements, and the what is non-transparent is considered to be not built, and what is transparent is considered to be built. And the elements you see as red are the elements that the algorithm is picking up to be deviated. So if I turn on, I will isolate again the HVAC systems so we can go closer and check those into detail. So I'm gonna isolate HVAC and if I turn on the point cloud, I can zoom in. So if I select an element, what I see here now is the highlighted with this blue outline element is the element that is the design intent. So basically the element that comes from the BIM model, and the orange element is the as-built element. So it's basically the element that the algorithm is picking up to be built on site. And if you inspect that, you can see the how the point cloud overlaps with this element, and you can verify that that's actually true. The algorithm has picked that to be correct. So this HVAC duct, and you can see that from the elements next to it. So you can tell early on that this HVAC duct has been built a little bit to the right. And on the left here, you can see the amount of deviation, which is 8.5 inches. And so what is interesting here is you get this notification early on. So this is already installed, but when they're planning to install this pipe, you can already tell that there's going to be a class here, and you can foresee that issue early on. So although the trade partner who is going to install this pipe is going to know that they're going to have some issues on site early on. You can change, if I turn off the point cloud, you can change the tolerance of the deviation. So if I switch to 1 inch, and we can change those to be in metric. This is in inches and feet because basically the company is based in the US. If I switch this to 1 inch, as you can imagine, especially for HVAC, you expect to see really a lot of elements to be deviated. But probably at 1 inch, it's usually okay, depending on the trade. But when things start to become a bit more critical is at 3 inches and above, right? So the question is if we have something at 6 inches so and above, which things really start to become really critical, and you have to cut those things early in order to avoid having problems in construction. And if I turn other trades on, if I turn off the HVAC, you can check the same with walls, ceilings, structure, which is one of the common things that we've been asked to do, to check the structural framing of the building, beams, columns, etc. I'm gonna switch the HVAC back on. I'm going to turn the interiors off. And obviously, one way to inspect things is while you are on the portal. But you also have the ability to export a deviations IFC. And what that does, it's basically you get a 3D model of all the red elements, and then you can import that into your coordination software. If it's Navisworks or BeamTrack, it's pretty common these days, and you can run a class detection outside of the platform in any coordination software that you might be using. And that's pretty much it. That's what we do.
Thank you very, very much, Dimitris. It was informative and very, very interesting. And we hope to see the future, right? So,
yeah, thank you so much. Good to be with you today.